I think STEM is the best thing ever because it encompasses so many things. You've got science, you've got technology, you've got engineering, you've got math. Under this umbrella of STEM and through all these classes, you can see how each sort of avenue is coming together.
I'm a chemical engineer by profession. I loved engineering. I really had a varied career. Then it just so attracted me to think about mentoring students and bringing kids to study STEM, something that I was passionate about.
STEM is really embedded in everything around us, in the chairs that we're sitting in, the furniture that the computers are sitting on. There was some element of design and engineering that went into that. There's just such a wealth of opportunities and possibilities.
The more you practice it and do it, and you're like, wow, I can make sense out of it. This is complicated, but I can break it down and make sense of it. The nitty gritty and the details. When you can see there can be multiple answers or multiple applications for something, I love when that happens.
I want them to have that feeling of accomplishment and the feeling of curiosity that what else is out there that I can do. Or when they struggle, and then at the end of the struggle, they figure out how to do the calculation, how to build the thing, the circuit works.
In the STEM classes I've taken so far,
computer integrated manufacturing,
engineering, architecture and engineering, intro to CAD,
biology,
robotics,
biotechnical engineering,
AP Calc,
cybersecurity,
medical terminology,
introduction to engineering and design,
AP chemistry,
and a few computer science classes. When you see it come to life, I feel like that is the most rewarding part of it. Some of the skills that I take from STEM, like I do use those in like other classes.
You have all these different input sides to a problem that you can also see in history where there's so many perspectives for everything that's happened. Analyzing essays, you have to look at many points of view.
You're in high school, you have a safety net, we're all here to support you. You really have your pick of what you want to do, what interests you, and what suits your personality.
A lot of times I was the only female in the classroom, and so I really wanted to also be an advocate and a champion for women. We're definitely narrowing the gap. There's still going to be a lot of opportunities for female voices to be heard.
And I'm seeing more and more female astronauts, and I'm seeing more and more female research be put out. That's making me think, and therefore making, you know, people who look up to me and then people who look up to them think, okay, yeah, I can do this.